Bienvenidos de nuevo a Vecinos, Neighbors. Soy Orlando Isaza y les voy a hacer como anfitrión hoy. Welcome again to a program of the second season of Neighbors, Vecinos. And today we're going to have a rather emotional at times and I suppose important event in our community. And that was the farewell party, if you can call it a party, to George Cantor and the former superintendent of the schools in Holyoke, and Tim Barrett, his assistant superintendent. This event was sponsored by the Union of Latin American Women, and it went, when did it happen? A couple of months ago, and it was at the high school. El programa de hoy va a ser exclusivamente para la despedida a los señores educadores George Cantor, que fue el superintendente de las escuelas públicas de Holyoke, y su asistente, el señor Tim Barrett. Como ustedes saben, por supuesto, estos fueron cambios bastante importantes y dramáticos en nuestra comunidad. En educación, en el último año, hemos perdido no solo una cantidad de dinero, sino de recursos humanos. Y este es el caso con la pérdida del señor George Cantor y su asistente Tim Barrett. Este evento fue auspiciado por la Unión de Mujeres Latinoamericanas y se llevó a cabo en la escuela secundaria, The High School, en Holyoke, Massachusetts. Por favor, estén con nosotros. Este es un evento importante para nuestra comunidad.
I met Mr. Barrett and Mr. Cantor in 1973. The same year I did my practice teaching under Mr. Barrett at Morgan School. Mr. Cantor was the director of the bilingual program. At that time, Mr. Cantor could not say even hola in Spanish. After several tries, his vocabulary has expanded to cómo está, buenos días, el jefe, don Jorge, and some other words that I don't come to mind at this time. Mr. Barrett was one of the few bilingual teachers of that period. Some years later, he became the director of the bilingual program. Under his leadership, the program expanded and at the same time provided job opportunities for bilingual and English as a second language teachers. In 1981, he was instrumental in the development and implementation of the desegregation plan in the city of Holyoke. He distinguished himself for his sincerity and sense of justice for the Hispanic community. While Mr. Barrett was busy making sure that our children received good and sound education, Mr. Cantor became the assistant superintendent. Mr. Barrett and Mr. Cantor formed a good and special team that has defended the children's rights to a better education. Several years later, Mr. Cantor became the superintendent of schools. Under his leadership, the Dean Vocational School was built, other schools built extensions, the teen clinic at the high school was created to provide services to teens, and new methods of teaching were piloted and adopted. This year was a hard one for the school system. There were many budgetary cuts that affected the services provided for children. These two people have been criticized and blamed for the poor economic situation of the city. Many times, society blames innocent people or groups for all society ills. These two persons have worked hard, and they deserve to be recognized by us, the Hispanic community. So today, we are honoring these two people in here. I'm going to say this in Spanish because I know. Conocí al señor Barrett y al señor Counter en el año 1973. Ese mismo año hice mi práctica para el magisterio bajo la tutela del señor Barrett en la escuela Morgan. El señor Counter era el supervisor del programa bilingüe. Para esa época, el señor Counter no decía ni hola en español. Durante los años siguientes, su vocabulario se ha expandido de hola, cómo está, el jefe, don Jorge, y algunas más que no recuerdo en este instante. El señor Barrett era uno de los pocos maestros bilingües que existían en el sistema escolar en aquella época. Unos años más tarde pasó a la posición de director del programa bilingüe. Bajo su dirección, el programa se expandió, al igual que la oportunidad de trabajo para maestros de habla española y maestros de inglés como segundo idioma. También él fue instrumental en el desarrollo del plan de desegregación en el año 1981. Siempre él se ha distinguido por su sinceridad y justicia para la comunidad hispana. Mientras el señor Barrett se ocupaba de que nuestros niños recibieran una educación adecuada, el señor Counter pasó a la posición de asistente al superintendente. Los señores Barrett y Counter formaron un equipo especial para defender los derechos de todos los niños en la ciudad de Holyoke. Unos años más tarde, el señor Counter pasó a la posición de superintendente del sistema escolar. En esta posición se hizo más fácil implementar las metas del programa bilingüe. Bajo la dirección del superintendente Counter se edificó la escuela vocacional DIN, se planificó la clínica para los adolescentes en la escuela superior, se edificaron extensiones a escuelas y se implementaron nuevos métodos de enseñanza. Este año fue un año muy fuerte para nuestro sistema escolar. Hubo muchos recortes debido a la situación económica del país. A estas dos personas se les ha criticado por el estado económico de la ciudad. Muchas veces se buscan excusas, a su vez se culpan personas o grupos por las plagas de la sociedad. Por la dedicación de estas personas a la comunidad, les hemos invitado esta tarde. Y a continuación...
Good evening. My name is Sandra Carver. I am a student at Morgan School. The students who will perform for you tonight are students from Morgan School, ranging from kindergarten to grade 2. We learn many things during our years at Morgan, most importantly that the United States is a country of many cultures and that each of us with our various backgrounds adds to its beauty. This performance is one of our culminating activities for our unit on handicapism. Sit back, relax, and enjoy. We will sing and sign for you. For our first number, we will sing the song It's a Small World. Mr. Counter and Mr. Barrett, we as children realize that this is a small world. Wouldn't it be a wonderful place in which to live if everyone could get along and be friends?
Small world that's for all.
Our next speaker is Felipe Pantoja. Felipe, also has been in the city for 22 years. He was the first Latino bilingual teacher in Hoyo, and he was with Mr. Barrett in 1970. He has three daughters. One already graduated from Holyoke High School, and I think the other two are at the Holyoke High School at this time. Felipe, where are you? Ladies and gentlemen, then Felipe Pantoja.
Mr. Cantor and Mr. Barrett have done history in Holyoke. It's history characterized by their dedication to our children. They are the most in need of all of our dedication and work. Mr. Cantor y Mr. Barrett han hecho historia en Holyoke. Es una historia caracterizada por su dedicación a los niños, estos que son los más necesitados de nuestra dedicación y trabajo. Both men, Mr. Cantor and Mr. Barrett, deserve our honor. They were empowered to create good things for our kids, and a better learning environment. And so they did it. Ambos hombres merecen nuestro honor. Tenían el poder de crear para nuestros niños lo mejor en el ambiente educativo y de aprendizaje, y así lo hicieron. However, to say goodbye is not an easy task now. We really would like to say hasta luego, so long. We instead want to say good luck in your new adventures, in your new jobs. We know they are going from the new job that they have now to a better job, and I hope I will see them in the best places in our educational systems. Holyoke continues to lose the best. They are at the top of the list of the good people that are living in Holyoke. What's Holyoke going to do when this emigration continues and is not stopped at all? Sin embargo, decir adiós no es una tarea fácil. Nosotros solamente quisiéramos decir hasta luego, so long. En vez de ello, nosotros queremos decirles buena suerte en sus nuevas aventuras y en sus nuevos trabajos. Esperamos que ellos lleguen desde estos nuevos trabajos a otros mejores, hasta que estén en las alturas de la educación en Estados Unidos. Holyoke continúa perdiendo lo mejor, y ellos están al tope de la lista de la gente buena que están dejando a Holyoke. ¿Qué va a hacer Holyoke como esta emigración continúe y esto no se ha parado? Mr. Cantor has become a symbol for us, for those of us who want to see him as a man who has been a real creative man in a school system that became a role model for many other school systems and departments of United States of America cities. El señor Cantor se convirtió en símbolo para aquellos de nosotros que lo hemos querido ver, de un hombre creador dentro de un sistema escolar que se convirtió en modelo para muchos otros sistemas y departamentos escolares de las ciudades de Estados Unidos de América. Mr. Barrett has become a pioneer in developing an educational sound bilingual education program that represents the best for our children in need of being in a school that helps them to grow and to learn. Mr. Barrett se ha convertido en un pionero desarrollando un programa educacional bilingüe de calidad que representa lo óptimo para nuestros niños en una escuela que los ayuda a crecer y a aprender. To both of you, thank you. Para ambos de ustedes, gracias.
For our second number, we will sing the song Like Me and You. This was a song written by Rafi for the 1984 Summer Olympics. We will also be doing sign language during the part of the song. When you listen to the words of the song, be aware that just as the world is made up of a patchwork of culture so Polio, diverse in its own right.
Miembro de nuestra comunidad ha sido admirable. Este año es su último año de trabajo en la ciudad de Holyoke. Y por eso le damos una calurosa despedida al señor Tim Barry y al señor George Counter. Nosotros no queremos que nos olviden, ni se olviden de la ciudad de Holyoke. Nosotros sabemos lo que se siente cuando uno sale del sitio que lo vio nacer. Nosotros también salimos de Puerto Rico por razones distintas y conocemos el vacío que se siente. Es por eso que le entregamos este póster enmarcado de la segunda fiesta puertorriqueña que se llevó a cabo en octubre de 1983. Gracias, Mr. Counter.
Back in 1990, Mrs. Felicity Delgadi first spoke to me about the Union of Latin American Women, a group which I later joined. I want to emphasize here tonight to all Hispanics present that through this group we have recognized our worth. We have also seen that the value of Hispanic women has not often been recognized by the community at large. If we unite, we'll succeed, because in unity there's strength. Tonight, the Union of Latin American Women is pleased to honor two outstanding individuals of our community. We know that the dedication and respect have worked toward our children's education. The relationship they have developed with the community is admirable. This has been their last year of work in our city of Holyoke, and that is why we're here to give Tim Barrett and George Counter a well-deserved and warm farewell. We do not want them to forget us or to forget the city of Holyoke. We know very well how it feels to leave the place where we were born. We also left Puerto Rico for different reasons, and we know the feeling of emptiness. That is why we would like to give you this poster from the second Puerto Rican party that took place in Holyoke in 1983.
Productive members of our society. For our third and final number, we will sing the song One Light, One Sun. Just as the sun lights the world, you, Mr. Counter, and you, Mr. Barrett, have lit a flame in the minds and hearts of many children, parents, and educators. And that light will burn brightly in Holyoke for many years to come.
Everyone. light warming everyone.
Para mí estar con ustedes esta noche acá para compartir la tristeza, quizá. ¡Bienvenido! Vale que nunca, ¿no? I was saying that it's a great honor for me to be able to speak here tonight to express what I think is a collective gratitude for two great people in our community and simultaneously a great deal of sadness. However, I will perhaps take the risk of saying things that need to be said. In looking at the headlines in the papers in the last couple of weeks, I have been astounded at the kind of general attitude that has been symbolized, I guess, by the press coverage on the departure of some of our greatest administrators and teachers in this city. There was a headline the other day in the front page that said something like, and I'm going to read because I will forget, Holyoke's top educators abandon ship. And a few days later, another one talked about Springfield, quote, steals key school leader. And then there was another one that said, art school benefactor may pull out. Please, think about those terms. Tim Barrett, Efrain Martinez, and George Counter are not abandoning the ship. They are being thrown overboard. The benefactor is not pulling out, they are being pushed out. They are being pushed out by a political system that is insensitive to the great majority of the needs of most of the people in this city today. And that means you, and that means our children. It simply means that the people of vision, the people who, quote, see our children as their children, even though they may be a little bit browner, or a bit poorer, or perhaps a heavy accent. These people dare to call our children their children, and they are being sacrificed today. And frankly, I think we need to assume a great deal of the shame and guilt in this process. Because we are in this never-ending cycle of accolades and praises to these people once they were sacrificed, and we didn't dare to do the same for them when it was time to leave them and keep them here where they belong. I don't know how it is that people like George Counter have the grace, I guess, and the courage to come to a graduation and ask of the children that are being graduated to please remember this great city and serve this great city. Now that is grace. That is generosity. That is wisdom. We should all be ashamed of a political system that is so narrow-minded as to not appreciate and what it was to deprecate and vilify people because they wanted the best for our future, because they wanted the best for our children. That's a shame on us. It's a shame on the political system of this city. Frankly, the only way I have to look at it is as a challenge. We need to replace these people with the best we can find in this nation, and we won't take any less than that. We need to demand a process of selection that represents us and our children, so that we can at least find people who may measure up to the quality and caliber of the ones who are leaving us, because, as I said, they are being driven out, they are being pushed out, they are being abandoned, they are being disowned because they dare to adopt our children as their own. Maybe rough to say these things, but hey, someone's got to say them. So, we have to say thanks to these people, but I think we have to say shame on all of us. Shame on all of us for not doing whatever possible to protect the integrity of these people who have done so much for us, and who have been, in the last few months, absolutely vilified in the press and essentially by the school committee as a group, and of course there are exceptions in that school committee as well. So I just hope that as a Hispanic community, as the parents of the children who are now being educated in this city, we begin to demand the best for our children. Because frankly, the best for our children is the best for the city. And until we recognize that, we will be forsaken ourselves, our children, and the memory of these great people who are having to live because they are not appreciated. Let me try to translate some of this into Spanish. Voy a decir un poco de esto en español porque de verdad es un poco difícil, ¿no? Porque ni siquiera me acuerdo de qué fue lo que dije. Pero yo creo que es importante que se digan esta noche acá cosas que no se han dicho hasta el momento en esta ciudad. En la prensa aparecen todos los días titulares diciendo de que el señor Barrett y el señor Canter y además nuestro propio Efraín Martínez están abandonando la ciudad. Que lo mejor de esta ciudad se está yendo a esta ciudad porque la quiere abandonar. Falso. No es porque quieran abandonar la ciudad, es porque la ciudad abandonó a esta gente. Es porque esta gente osó, ellos osaron adoptar a nuestros hijos como sus hijos propios. Y es por eso que se están sacrificando. Que un sistema político que no nos representa a nosotros, sino representa los intereses de nuestros hijos, los está abandonando a ellos. No son ellos quienes nos abandonan al sistema, es el sistema quien nos abandonó a ellos. Es un sistema que no los ha apreciado, que no los ha querido por más que hagan, porque lo están haciendo por lo nuestro. Por eso es. Entonces, francamente, con toda la gratitud que les tenemos que tener, tenemos que mirar su salida como un desafío a nuestro pueblo, a organizarse, a defender lo bueno y a demandar que sean reemplazados por lo mejor del país, por lo mejor para todo nuestro pueblo, no solo nuestra comunidad hispana, sino todo el pueblo en esta ciudad. Porque, francamente, lo que no se entiende es que el futuro de la ciudad, por más que no se quiera entender, es el futuro de nuestros hijos. Y al menos que se eduque a nuestros hijos con calidad, con generosidad, con compasión, no hay futuro para esta ciudad. Entonces, francamente, es con tristeza que tenemos que decir hasta luego, hasta la próxima. Muchas gracias, Jorge y Timoteo. Timoteo, ¿no? Muchas gracias por todo. Y francamente, aunque no sé si va a ocurrir, Me tomo un poco más de segundos acá para agradecer profundamente y de la misma manera que lo estamos haciendo esta noche para George y Tim, para agradecerle a Efraín Martínez. No sabemos lo que estamos perdiendo. Es otro que se nos va. No se nos va porque lo quiere, se nos va porque no lo quisimos. Que nos, por lo menos, nos enseñe una lección para el futuro, para empezar a prevenir que suceda lo que está sucediendo y lo que ha sucedido. Que nunca más suceda. Que la próxima vez sepamos de antemano lo que está sucediendo y salgamos a defender a quienes nos defiendan antes de que se tengan que ir ellos. Muchas gracias.
Bueno, le tenemos un regalo a Mr. Barrett y Bruce se lo van a entregar.
Buenas noches. Y ustedes no saben cómo me siento estar con ustedes otra vez después de una semana, dos semanas de trabajo en otro sitio. Me siento bien cómodo estar con ustedes. De verdad me siento como es. Aquí debo de estar yo. Pero, veremos a ver. It's wonderful to be back with you tonight. I've just left high school graduation in my new community, and that was uplifting. It's been a busy week, and I've just spent a couple of hours in the car, and I'm a little overwhelmed by everything that I'm seeing and hearing here tonight. But I just want to thank you from the bottom of my heart for all of the wonderful years that we had working together. We may have said so long, but it's not goodbye. I'll be back often. There'll be many occasions when I'll come and visit. I hope that I can come and help plan good things. We can still continue to share. I miss you all already, but things are going well. So I really don't know what more to say tonight, other than there's lots to think about. There are lots of wonderful memories. Y que siempre ha sido mi orgullo, mi placer trabajar con esta comunidad, y les agradezco del alma todo lo que me han brindado durante los años, y espero seguir compartiendo. Y ustedes, pues, para adelante siempre. Gracias.
From a distance, the ocean meets the stream. Buenas noches. ¿Cómo está?
Muchas gracias. Los niños. Let me be very brief, because we have to dance. It's time to dance. Dancing relieves the soul and the heavy heart. I want to thank the children. The children. That's why we are here. The children were so beautiful tonight. And they had their message to all of us in their words, in their song. And it was so emotional to hear them, because the children are okay. It's the adults that are screwed up.
I hope they treat us better than we treated them. You know, it's really true. It says somewhere that the children will lead. And I really think that the future of our city is in our children. And we need to have faith in them that they're going to overcome all of the craziness that's going on with the adults. They're fine. We just have to believe and trust that they're going to do okay. I think that they will. Number two, I never really appreciated what it meant to leave someplace that you love very dearly. You know what that's about. You sing about it in your songs of old San Juan. And the Irish sing about it in their songs when they left Ireland. But you don't appreciate it until you have to leave. And I have to leave. And it's been very hard. I have to leave a city that I love, a school system that I love, children that I love, and people that I love. And it's hard. I don't have to tell you that. It's hard. But although we leave, as Felipe said tonight, and Timmy mentioned it, although I'm leaving, you know that my heart stays. And that although I will be in some other place, my heart will always be here. My mother lived on Center Street in the flats. And my father lived in War II, Sahoyo. They found each other and they had three children. My father worked in the mills, left school in grade 8. My mother left school in grade 8. She worked in National Blankville. There was work for them. The mills provided a life for them so that they could have a family and that their children could be educated and go to school. It's harder for you. It's harder. But the schools are the way for our children, as they were for me and my brothers. And they are the way for your children. You know that, and I know that. There are a lot of people out there that don't know that, or they don't care about them. They don't care about the children. And when you finish the public schools in Hoyo, you go to Hoyo Community College. And you go to the University of Massachusetts or Westfield State or a state college or university. That's the way. That's the way you do it. When I went to Westfield State College, it was $100 a year. $60 in September, $40 in January. To go to Holyoke Community College today is $2,500. It's wrong. It's wrong, wrong, wrong. You have to make it different. For your children. For your children. And your grandchildren. You have to be sure that they have an opportunity, or their chances will be less. The schools are the way. Education is the way. Barrett, my friend Barrett, I taught him all the Spanish he knows. He's doing okay. He's doing okay in the Spanish. He lived in Churchill. He lived in Churchill. Delivered newspapers on the porches. Went to Holyoke Community College and to Amherst College. It's the way. It's the way for your children and all of the children of this country. That's what America is all about. Democracy is all about. And when I go to Thomaston, Connecticut, there are many children there who are poor, who don't go anywhere when they finish school. They don't go anywhere. They think they're going to get a job in the mills in Waterbury. There's no mills in Waterbury anymore. So they do nothing. So I will fight those fights. If you have friends in Waterbury, let me know. I'll look them up. We'll do the Baringa in Waterbury. Here we come. We're coming to Connecticut. I love you dearly. You have been so good to me. You have been so good to me. And in the song in Old San Juan, it talks about leaving and how hard it is. But it talks about the hope of returning. And I know that I will. Let's dance.
Now that he's wedding in Guayabera, I have to go back to Puerto Rico.
Espero que ustedes hayan disfrutado mucho de nuestro programa de hoy. Espero que se queden con nosotros en cada programa que llevemos a sus hogares. Son eventos de importancia, son puntos de vista importantes para la comunidad. Thank you again. I hope you enjoyed our program today, and I certainly hope you'll return to see us. Till next week. Vecinos, neighbors.